My name is Charmaine Crooks, and I'm proud to be here on the traditional Coast Salish territory. I'm proud to be part of tonight's celebration as we desire a better country. And when I looked at that word desire, the longing, the hoping for, to express a wish for, and to invite, I was reminded quite deeply that it would only be 7 minutes of how I can express the 150 years of how Canada has shaped me, in part from running 2 minutes around a track or 400 meters around a track for five Olympic teams. But the number that resonates with me most as we look and as we help shape and desire a better country is the number 13, because that is when I took my oath of Canadian citizenship. That is when my family moved from Jamaica to Canada, and they had a dream, like many immigrant families that have moved here from far away countries, whether as refugees or whether as immigrants coming to help build Canada. We came here in the 60s at a time when we were coming to help shape this great nation. And there are countless stories from immigrants all across our country of how they have shaped and how they have contributed to Canadian society. And we came here because of the opportunities that Canada presented to us, its open doors, its open arms, and its open community that I was proud to be part of when I was growing up in Toronto. And as we gather here in Surrey tonight, I'm reminded too of the many immigrants who live in this great and growing community, who were also brought here because of the opportunities of Canada and because they want to contribute, and how Canada has welcomed us all with open arms. But for us and my family, it did start as that dream. But part of that dream became for me a destiny. It was a destiny to contribute to this country through a common desire. But my parents taught me, like many immigrant parents, about the value of education and how it was important to have that as the basis, as really the foundation for my future. But really, for me, it was sport. It was sport past the running that went into the leadership roles that allowed me to become an advocate for athletes as the very first athlete to be part of the elected IOC Athletes Committee, and to see some of the things that were happening around there in sport and some of the changes that were going on and some of the changes that we had to bring to the table. And I knew that what I was bringing was because of my Canadian context, that Canadian context that invites listening, it invites the opportunity for us to contribute in a constructive manner to the world and to bring those desires back to our country and help to make our country a better place through sport. So why sport? At its core, it is about play. At its core, it's about access. It's about celebration, and it's also about inspiration. And I don't need to remind many of us across Canada of the inspiration that we see when we see our Olympians and Paralympians compete on the world stage and that pride that it brings into our communities. It is about excellence, and it's also about setting goals. And with the global challenges that are happening now in so many quarters of sport, we are reminded of the leadership role that many Canadians can play and do play in making change. But we also recognize that building a better Canada, we must constantly strive to promote health in our citizens and open our doors for sports so all of us will have the opportunity to be part of that. I truly believe that the lessons that I've learned from sport are not unlike what the arts or the sciences or culture also embraces. When we as Canadians can spread our wings and show the world what we can do and what we have to also contribute. Yes, it is about excellence in sport when you watch the athletes and they compete and we're in awe of them. But we also recognize that sport is really, in many ways, a catalyst of our communities. It's about sharing. It's about making sure that we all have access to be at the table to make decisions, not only for ourselves as athletes, but also on the board tables as well. You know, diversity and inclusion are something which women in sport are always striving for every day. And I was taught very early that in order for us as nine, growing up as nine children, there were only six seats at the table. And we all had to, you know, run in order to get to the table in time. Otherwise, you got to wait the next shift. Some of you know about that. But in Canada, we must never forget that we cannot be complacent. And even though there might be six seats at that table, we must fight to be at that table so we can be part of that change and we can show the leadership that Canada is inherently known for. But we must also use innovation and constantly being part of the new dialogue that is helping to shape the world in sport. But I also believe that it's important for us to think globally, but also act locally, and never forget that somewhere around the corner, there is another immigrant or refugee child who wants to be part of that society that we call Canada. That society which we talk about being diverse, but we can't forget that we must always strive to be inclusive, meaning that keeping us all at the table so we can share in that dialogue. And so let us all invite each other to truly be at that table, to truly be at that table and have a strong dialogue about what it means to be Canadian in the context of the reflection of our athletes who are the global ambassadors around the world showcasing us. And also, finally, to remind us that there are a lot of kids out there dreaming of what I did and what I was able to accomplish in sport. And we cannot do that unless we continue to showcase who we are, support our local communities, so that way they can also continue and want to dream and desire to be better Canadians and to represent our country and be the ambassadors that they deserve to be. Thank you very much.